session, I'll talk about the JMOOC. First, let me talk about the very brief story about JMOOC. We started from the JMOOC's activities to start from 2013 October. It's the announcement of JMOOC establishment. That is the press conference we held in the October 11th. The center is our president, Dr. Katsuhiko Shirai, the former president of Waseda University. And next to him, the left-hand side, is the president, former president of Keio University, Yuichiro Anzai, the vice president of our university. And the right-hand side of the Dr. Katsuhiko is there. Professor Yasura, he's the vice president of Kyushu University right now. And the next month, November 2013, we officially established as the non-profit general incorporated association. It's very, how to say, the independent organization from the government, the very private, but a non-profit. And next year, the February of 2014, we started the opening the registration of the first courses, first three courses. And from the April, the first MOOC course we opened. At that time, the two platforms operated by organization. The first one is named Gakko. This is operated by NTT Docomo, our Japanese mobile carrier, the one of the three big mobile carrier, and the subsidiary company of the mobile Docomo, NTT Docomo Gakko. Gakko is really supported, operated by operation. Give the operation of the Gakko platform. And the other one is the OUJ MOOC, is operated by the Open University of Japan. And September, the next platforms are joined. This is named Open Learning Japan. It's operated by a private e-learning company, NetLearning. And last year, March, the fourth JMOOC platform, certified platform, joined. It's operated by Fujitsu, you know, the IT company, Japanese IT company Fujitsu, operated, give the operation. So far, for the total of four platforms, the 155 pro courses are provided. And we have the JMOOC portal, www.jmoocjp. We can provide the all the access to the oral contents provided by the four platforms. Actually, our portal is here. First, you can access. Maybe it's presented in Japanese here, but please go to the bottom side. You can see the English button here. Let me. No gender for the foreigner, but. Please allow us. This is an English version, and you can see the all of the contents by each course card here. Those are the now open the course and those are the contests right now here. You can access for each content through the single sign-on using the Open ID. If you have the Facebook ID or Google ID, Google Plus, you can use the single sign-on. Just signing on the JMOOC side, you can select any platform, Open Learning or Gakko or Fizam or Open Learning in Japan. This graph shows the pie chart shows the subjects, the total 25% of the courses we developed is we delivered is about the humanities, and the next the computer science and programming 19%, and the business and management is 70%, and some. This graph shows the enrollment. The unique learners registered is 279 commas of positions wrong. 279,000, and total runners are 670,000. And this learner's profile, the about age, 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s are almost 20%, 60s are 10%, and less than 10 and more than 70 is each 5%. Oh. And the education background, the more than 70% is the undergraduate and more. The profession, the full-time and part-time, maybe about 70%. I made the polls for the learners. This is one of the questions. Where did you run MOOC mainly? The about half, less than half, just a little bit less than half answered from home. But the other half and plus answered the outside home. The office, school, transportation, lesson, and some. And the terminals used for the JMOOC, the PC, answered PC is 60%, and the smartphone 20%, tablet 11, and Nano 90. Right. JMOOC is operated by the membership fee. The, we provide the four categories of membership. One is a special members. The special member have to pay ¥500,000 per year. And for a regular member, 500,000 yen per year, and most of the universities are regular members, so they paid annual dues, Right now, 50 universities joined as a regular member, and 32 companies joined as a regular member also. And other non-profit organization or research institute joined as a supporting members. Supporting members also have to pay due 100,000 yen per year. Let me talk about the JMOOC mission statement. JMOOC strongly leads and aims to bring it to reality MOOC's vision to expand individual values to the whole of society's shared value through learning for Japan and Asia based on business academia collaboration. And the aims of the JMOOC is enlarging the social recognition of MOOC certificate, establishment of social infrastructure of lifelong learning, cooperation and alliance among Asian countries and MOOC, on MOOC courses and platform, establishment of a methodology for flipped learning, enforcement of research for learning analytics. Those are our aims. It's very difficult to see, but this organization, we have board members and under board members. We have steering committee and some working groups to investigate some topics. We have now six working group. It's a quality research working, continued study working, new learning style working, value create working, learning log analytics, and study support working, and the global alliance working. Next, let me talk about the JMOOC features. We are not depends on the specific organization like huge company, nor foundation in terms of finance. The financial support, regarding financial support, we don't get the huge money from foundation or government. Operations are carried out with only membership dues from each members, special members and regular members. Cost delivery, regarding cost delivery, is not only from top-ranked universities, but also from many various universities if they are the regular members and more. And we provide courses mainly in Japanese, supporting many Japanese learners and expecting good quality courses in Japanese from JMOOC rather than English. We are very much focusing on the learner-centric approach. As I said, we provide many, four platforms, so our features are multi-platform basis. JMOOC certified multiple platforms, Gakko or JMOOC, Open Learning Japan, and FISDAM. And next feature is the universal access and usability. We put the subtitles, mostly Japanese. All of the courses have their subtitles in Japanese, and some are English. This depends on the universities for every groups. And most of the courses can run by the smartphone and the tablet. Each course is fragmented by the 10 minutes video each. So next, I'd like to talk about the quality assurance through course certification. Based on our professional knowledge and experiences, all of our online lectures are examined to see if they fulfill the standards we require in a massive open online courses. The courses that pass this examination process are qualified as JMOOC certified course and divided into one of the following three categories based on the institutional that provides the courses and the contents of the course itself. We defined three categories, and then each category is put the this type of logo. And the left hand side one is a category one. Category means the university level courses provided by universities. The contents are very equivalent for the courses provided by universities for the credit. And the next one is the right hand side is a category two. It's a courses provided by technical colleges or vocational schools. But those contents are the very equivalent for the courses provided those institutions for the credit. And the center is a category three. So the category three means the other any kind of courses if they meet the MOOC regulation. And our courses, aims, we provide high quality course for free. All of the courses are still free. We offer opportunities to take university level courses with a simple course registration and the entire learning process, including viewing lecture videos, getting grad pro test and assignments. And the receiving certificate for completion is provided completely free of charge. A wide variety of learners from age under 20 over 80 are taking our courses, and some of them will not have been able to access this level of education otherwise. And third one is the research for the establishment of learning support technology. Regarding the faculty development, we are now planning to deliver the courses for instructional design, instructional designing for the course developer. Unfortunately, in Japanese universities, very behind regarding the instruction design. So actually, only two schools provided their instructional design courses in Japan. So one of them are from the Kumamoto University. I asked the Kumamoto University's instruction design professor to develop instruction design courses for MOOC developers. So maybe just started to planning to develop. So after half a year or a year, we can provide those courses by JMOOC platform, through JMOOC platform. So we are now make a proposal for the Ministry of Education and other ministry to have the cooperation in terms of the using MOOC for their policy, like just I mentioned in the morning. And we would like to have a good cooperation with Asian countries regarding the MOOC. So there may be the it's a very first step. Is it the MOU signing in this March? And it's our very basic idea for the cooperation. Just an example. My proposal. The exchange of the courses each other, exchanging courses each other. Japanese courses are delivery from other countries platform for learners in those countries. Maybe first step, use Japanese courses for learning. Maybe it's good for Japanese learning, I think. The Open University of Japan provide the courses for learning Japanese, and other courses, we put the subtitles to the all of the courses, so it could be the good contents to learn Japanese in each subject. And the second step, learning contents itself in mother tongue, which have been translated by learners in first step. Maybe the subtitles are in Japanese. It's easily, relatively easily, can be translated for the mother tongue form of the each countries like Thai, Vietnam, and some. And the other aspect, they are sharing various experiences and know-how through MOOC project, learning analytics, some technologies for FCN developmental courses. We have many challenges. The mainly most important thing is how can we enhance the our recognition, MOOC recognition. At the moment, still very low rate of the recognition about the MOOC in Japan. So it's very important to raise recognition more. The particular recognition on high school and university students, the very little percentage of the existing students, high school students, using MOOC. I think at that time in Japan, no. Reason for those high school students and university students to use MOOC. So we should create the some realistic needs or a realistic value for them to use MOOC. And next one is the establishment of a social value on MOOC certificates. At that moment, at that time, in Japan, it's very difficult to make their MOOC certificate to very equal to the university's credit. The university credit is very much controlled by the next Ministry of Education's regulation. It's very rigid regulation to give the official credit equivalent to the university level. So they meet the condition of the adoption of the one criteria for human resource management in the companies. So we are now planning to provide the complementary use for the business person. First, we start from the engineers to improve their skills for the real work in the society. And the third one is the last one is the establishment of research environment for learning analytics. We have already some amount of accumulation of learning data, but unfortunately, it's not used for the feedback, good feedback for the research or education. So we should encourage the research community to make the more research project using our data for moving forward the learning analytics field. Lastly, let me talk about the our site once more again. Sorry, it's in all in Japanese, but this type of same design courses, four courses, about the running technologies, basic technologies. It's electric circuits and how to say it, yeah. Control engineering or something, management of quality management, and metal material something. I'm not sure the exact English. We now, at the moment, the first four courses are started for. These four courses are open for the January 17 for running, and most of the our courses, other courses are. Almost 4 weeks long. We decided the regulation for the MOOC's contents mainly 4 weeks. The main reason why we define the four courses is the runners' activity to get the completion with the short term first. So if the university want to provide the whole course, we suggest them to divide three JMOOC courses. But this kind of four courses that have to run engineering basics, it needs more long courses. So most of the those courses are from 6 weeks and 8 weeks. And the those six logos are the, from the special members company, Docomo, and AFP, Sumitomo Corporation, and it's a Toshin High School prep school, the most famous prep school in Japan, and Netrunning and Fujitsu, and other regular members are here. Or most of the top upper side is the university. Now 50 universities are the members. Most of them are private, and some national universities, like Hokkaido University and the Tohoku University. So in Japan, the most of the top-ranked private universities are already members. And the bottom side is the company. Most of them are the related to the education fields or IT fields. We are now recruiting other companies for supporting JMOOC. I think they are providing the learning technology basics. They are a good opportunity to recruit many of the big companies related to the heavy industry or information technology or electronics field. And just the supporting members, many of them are a non-profit organization and research institute. So there are remaining maybe 10 minutes and more as for Q&A. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Yoshimi. Now, questions time, please. Please, Chan Kamolat.
Sorry if I ask so many because I'm really commit to move on MOOC in my university. Just quick question that you mentioned that you offer the university course in the JMOOC and for free. How can you sustain yourself?
Our organization is operated by the membership dues, membership fees. I'd like to add one more thing. The universities, if we university joined as a JMOOC member, and they decided to provide the course, we provide the $5,000 for their the course development. Only first time, but we provide the financial support for the universities to develop a course. $5,000.
I have one question. From your information, it's really interesting because you have many private organizations that are very big name to join to this JMOOC. How can you start to make them trust that this way of learning is good for them? and then they join and then provide you money like that.
It was a very tough job. But maybe they trust us for the top executive person. The JMX president is the former president of the Waseda University, and the vice president is also the former president of Keio University. And the other one is right now, the current vice president of Kyushu University. It's one of the top-ranked national universities. Those are the top executives of the JMOOC. And we, of course, promoted the widely. And at the beginning, the establishment time, the many publishers, the press companies, published the big news. The JMOOC started. The Japanese MOOCs are about to provide. So the the most biggest press, Asahi Shimbun Press, make the our establishment press conference at the top news of the first page. That is the one of the trust. And the other one is the joining of the main universities first. Our university, Waseda University, or Kyushu University, Keio University. Those are the became the members. That is the one of the trust for the companies to join. And the other last factor is the some big companies think if they have one of the business opportunity to enter this field, like NTT Docomo and Fujitsu and other net running company or some, they think must be the huge market in future. So they joined as a special member.
Any more questions, please? I think this is very interesting model, very different from all of us. And yet he is so humble, he said he needs to create more social value. But indeed, he has a lot of already recognition from the public, from the press, from many companies backing you up. This is a kind of success model that we can look up.
Professor also saying that the still very low recognition among the youngster or the high school. So it's quite different, you know. You're saying that you gain the trust from many known company, but along the way, still this group still very low recognition. So.
But first, maybe the start from the person who are the already graduated to the school universities first. But next time, I think the after the some amount of the courses. After those courses are developed, it could be a good educational resources for universities to teach students in a university, maybe. If after those activities are started, the existing student can know and can use. After that, maybe it's influenced to the high school students, I think. So the one of the important things is the number of courses. It's the critical mass of the courses. I'm not sure the actual number of the course for the critical mass, but maybe more than 500. Right now, there are 116 more, so the 3-4 times required.
Just curious to know, as far as I know that you have three different platforms, right?
Four different platforms.
But you combine all courses from each different platform into one website, right?
So JMOOC portal.
JMOOC portal. So when the student register to each individual courses, so they go to different platform, right?
Right. Oh, right. So, one of the issues is existing in this structure. At the moment, we cannot gather the running logs so consolidated style. It's very difficult to get the running data from each platform because of the privacy problem. They have the very rigid privacy policy. It's very difficult to provide the private data from each platform. So now we are discussing about the how can we solve that problem, and gather the all of the running data in one style.
Any more questions, please? This is the chance. Okay, please.
Yeah. I'm so sorry. Actually, I have created the online course communication and media for ASEAN. So I'm very interested in your presentation that you're saying that you are also trying to expanding among the ASEAN country. What exactly the priority or the plan of that?
We have the five important activity for annually. The international activity is the one of the five, but it's not put the priority for five. It's the same five important annual activity we are now moving forward. So going so and one or two or some universities are also very much very interested in the collaboration, international collaboration in Asian countries. So the maybe we can support the such kind of the collaborative project joining the many universities here.
You mean that the interest university is the local university among the ASEAN member country or what? Or the university in Japan?
At the moment, university in Japan, we don't access to the university in other countries.
I would like to ask you about the course evaluation. Since you have many universities join JMOOC, the policy of the learning achievement or the certificate, it depends on the universities or JMOOC got guidelines or something. Thank you.
Yeah, we created guidelines and we have the course, how to say, the evaluate, not evaluate, certificating committee. So we after when once the university decided to provide a course, they apply the our JMOOC to the format for the course application. So the course application format the make the for the approval for course certification committee of JMOOC. After the approval, they can start to create a course.
It means that you check it since like a course agreement before go to the step of course development, right?
Yes, but the we check the it's the fit for the each category. So if the, this for the category 3, it's very easy to deliver. But they want to provide as a category 1, we check the whether it's very much it's the very equivalent to the courses provided the university itself. We checked.
And this continue to your answer that do you have any checklist that we can share, you can share for us? Thank you. Thank you.
The one maybe different thing the KMOOC or TIMOOC things, I think the any university can provide course in Japan. So, but the we check it's the suitable for the providing from JMOOC, the based on the checklist, and we think the final evaluation is the by the learners. Ah, one more thing. Of course, the even in the category 3, we don't approve the like gamble or something entertaining, too much entertainment or something. We don't give the approval for the. It's not good for the JMOOC contents. So, very basic regulation for the content itself.
Okay, so far, Professor Yoshimi has shared with us his secrets. And more secrets as we have more discussion. So please give him a big hand again, please. Thank you so much. Okay, ladies and gentlemen,